गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू बीएससी 2/4 सेमेस्टर जूलॉजी ऑनलाइन क्लास। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन द अल्ट्रा स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ राइबोसोम, इट्स डेफिनेशन, साइज, लोकेशन एंड फंक्शन। डेफिनेशन, while examining the animal and plant cell through a microscope, you might have seen numerous organelles that work together to complete the cell activities. See, when we observe the plant or animal cell under the microscope, the cytoplasm has number of organelles to complete the activities of the cell. One of the essential cell organelles are ribosomes. One of the main cell organelles present in these cells to perform the synthesis of proteins are ribosomes, which are in charge of protein synthesis. The ribosome is a complex made up of protein and RNA. Ribosome is made up of protein and RNA, and which adds up to numerous million Daltons in size and assumes an important part in the course of decoding the genetic message. Yes, it takes part in decoding the genetic message coming from the DNA reserved in the genome into protein. So the genome, the message for the synthesis of protein is present in the genome. Genome is present in the chromosome. So this is the cell, animal cell. This is the nucleus, nuclear envelope, and so these particle like structures are ribosomes. The essential chemical step of protein synthesis is peptidyl transfer, that the developing or nascent peptide is moved from one transfer RNA molecule to the amino acid together with another tRNA. Amino acids are included in the developing polypeptide in line with arrangement of codons of mRNA. The ribosome therefore has necessary sites for one mRNA and no less than two transfer RNAs. So ribosome has sites for transfer RNAs as well as mRNA. Made of two subunits, ribosomes are made up two subunits, the big and the little subunit, which comprises a couple of ribosomal RNA molecules and an irregular number of ribosomal proteins. Numerous protein factors catalyze distinct impression of protein synthesis. The translation of the genetic code is essential significance for the manufacturing of useful proteins and for the growth of the cell. Structure: ribosomes are made up of proteins and ribonucleic acid in almost equal amounts. It comprises of two sections known as subunits. The tinier subunit is a place where the mRNA binds and it decodes, whereas the bigger subunit is the place the amino acids are included. So this is smaller subunit. To this small subunit, mRNA is attached. This is mRNA, and this one is larger subunit. To this larger subunit, amino acids are added, amino acids. Can you see here? So this is polypeptide chain. So large subunit of ribosome, amino acids. This one is transfer RNA. Transfer RNA brings the amino acids from the cytoplasm to the ribosome for the synthesis of polypeptide chain. Both segments comprise both ribonucleic acid and protein components and are linked to each other by interaction between the proteins in one subunit and the RNAs in the other subunit. The ribonucleic acid is obtained from the nucleolus, the ribonucleic acid RNA. For the ribosome is obtained from the nucleolus. Nucleolus is present inside the nucleus at the point where ribosomes are arranged in a cell. Ribosomes are situated in two areas of the cytoplasm, scattered in the cytoplasm, and few are connected to the endoplasmic reticulum. Whenever joined to the ER, they are called rough endoplasmic reticulum. Free and bound ribosomes are very much alike in structure and are associated with protein synthesis. Around 37 to 62% of RNA is comprised of RNA and the rest is proteins. Now around 37 to 62% of ribosome is comprised of RNA and rest is proteins. Prokaryotes have 70S ribosomes respectively, subunits comprising the little subunits 30S and the bigger subunit 50S. Prokaryotes have 70S ribosome. Smaller subunit is of 30S and larger subunit is of 50S. So both together form 70S ribosome. Whereas in eukaryotes, it is 80S. Eukaryotes have 80S ribosomes respectively comprising of little 40S and larger one is 60S subunits. Ribosomes seen in the chloroplasts of mitochondria, of eukaryotes are comprising of big and little subunits composed of proteins inside a 70S particle. In mitochondria and chloroplasts of eukaryotes, ribosomes are of 70S type. So ribosomes are present in the cytoplasm or present on the surface of endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic reticulum, or they are present inside the cell organelles like chloroplasts and mitochondria. Chloroplasts and mitochondria containing ribosomes are of 70S type. See, both are sharing a structure which is very much alike to all ribosomes in spite of changes in size. RNA is arranged in different tertiary structures. The RNA in the bigger ribosomes is into numerous continuous infusions as they create loops out of the center of the structure without disturbing or altering it. Contrast between those of eukaryotic and bacteria are utilized to make antibiotics that can crush bacterial disease without damaging human cells. Ribosome size. Ribosomes comprise of two subunits that are suitably composed and function as one to translate the mRNA into a polypeptide chain. Amid protein synthesis, due to the fact that they are made from two subunits of differing size, they are a little longer in the hinge and in diameter. They vary in size between prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. As I told you, the prokaryotic is composed of 30S and 50S subunits, meaning 70S for the entire organelle, equal to the molecular weight of 2.7 into 106 Daltons. Prokaryotic ribosomes are about 20 nanometer in diameter and are made of 35% ribosomal proteins and 65% ribosomal RNA. Notwithstanding, the eukaryotic are amidst 25 to 30 nanometer in diameter. They comprise of 40s and 60s subunit, which means 80s for the entire organelle, which is equal to the molecular weight 4 into 1.106 daltons. Location: ribosomes are organelles located inside the animal human cell. In plant cells, they are situated in the cytosol, some bound and free floating to the membrane of the coarse endoplasmic reticulum. They are utilized in decoding DNA to proteins, and no ribosomal RNA is forever bound to the RER. They release or bind as directed by the kind of protein they proceed to combine. In an animal or human cell, there could be up to 10 million ribosomes, and numerous ribosomes can be connected to the equivalent mRNA strand. This structure is known as polysome. Polysome is structure containing single mRNA with number of ribosomes. Number of ribosomes are connected to single mRNA to produce many copies of same type of protein. Polysomes are formed. Function of ribosomes. When it comes to the main function of ribosomes, they assume the role of bringing together amino acids to form particular proteins, which are important for completing the cell's activities. For various cell activities, proteins are required. All proteins are synthesized by the ribosomes. Protein is required for numerous cell functions, for example, directing chemical processes or fixing the damage. Ribosomes can yet be discovered floating inside the cytoplasm or joined to the endoplasmic reticulum. Other functions. Procedure of creation of proteins. The deoxyribonucleic acid makes mRNA by the step of DNA transcription. So mRNA is synthesized by the DNA by the process called transcription. Hereditary information from the mRNA is converted into proteins amid DNA translation. So the information, genetic information which is present in the mRNA, is converted into proteins with the help of ribosomes. The arrangements of proteins assembly and amid protein synthesis are indicated in the mRNA. The mRNA is arranged in the nucleus and is moved to the cytoplasm for an additional operation of protein synthesis. Proteins which are arranged by the ribosomes currently in the cytoplasm are utilized outside the cytoplasm by itself. The proteins created by the bound ribosomes are moved outside the cell. So with this, we have completed the structure of ribosomes. So the assignment for this chapter is: write the structure of ribosome in brief and give any two functions of the ribosome. So two questions. Number one, draw the diagram, explain the structure of ribosome. Second question is, write any two functions of the ribosome. Thank you.